Today, I'm about to dig deep into the medical world and shed some light on the worst diseases and other horrible conditions that our favorite idols suffer from. So, get ready for some heartbreaking stories. B2B's pineal, alopecia. Jean Pineal from B2B was at one point fighting a disease that no one wants to even think of. The talk is about a condition called alopecia. When a person suffers from alopecia, they experience a terrible hair loss, which you can probably imagine is one of the biggest nightmares of any idol. Pineal found out about this thanks to his hairstylist. She was doing his hair and warned him about a bald spot that appeared on his head. One week after that, he got another spot, and before he even realized what was happening, he had lost almost 70% of his hair. This took a big toll on his psychological health too, because he was scared that his career would be over and that no one would like him anymore. He even went back to the US to catch a break and relax. Surprisingly, his hair grew back. Why? When he escaped the K-pop craziness, he also stopped feeling so stressed and could think about lighter things. Pineal won the fight against alopecia thanks to a healthy approach to life. I mean, bald or not, we love you anyway, Pineal. BTS's V, cholinergic urticaria. Starting off a bit strong, but the dearest member of BTS, Kim Taehyung, is actually suffering from a very scary medical condition. It's a sort of allergy that is called cholinergic urticaria. Yeah, I know, the name sounds terrible, but imagine how people who are diagnosed with the disease feel. The allergy causes one of the worst outbreaks of hives that one can possibly think of. People who are dealing with this get a lot of red itchy spots on their bodies, and their urge to not scratch it is probably eating them up from inside out. But how do we know that Taehyung actually suffers from this? Well, our boy revealed it himself in 2019 on his BTS Weverse account. He reacted to one of the comments from his fans and said, "I have a cholinergic allergy. I'm itchy itchy." Poor guy, the red rash that appears on Taehyung's body creates small bumps that most likely makes him feel extremely uncomfortable. Some people who suffer from this peculiar allergy can experience abdominal pain, dizziness, and even difficulty with breathing. Now, you ain't ready for what happened after V shared this information with his fans. The power of ARMY came through, and out of nowhere, cholinergic urticaria was trending on various platforms. The term actually became number one on Naver's real-time search rankings. I mean, that speaks for itself. Hyuna, vasovagal syncope. There's no doubt that Hyuna is one of the most successful female artists from K-pop, and although she's been thriving in her career life, the same cannot be said about her health status. In 2016, she's been diagnosed with a condition that sounds like it's something out of a horror movie. The name is vasovagal syncope, and it is a condition that makes your life a living hell. People who suffer from this tend to faint when they are met with certain triggers such as blood, or when they are put in extremely stressful situations. Not only that, but Hyuna has been diagnosed also with depression and panic attacks the same year. She's been taking medicine for all these conditions for over 5 years now and tries her very best every day. After she left Cube Entertainment and signed with P Nation, she was supposed to come out with her album, I Am Not Cool, a year earlier, but the company delayed her comeback because her health was getting much worse. And even though Hyuna was spending her time getting better, she lost an incredible amount of weight while doing so. Now she's trying to get back on the right track and had promised everyone to stay healthy. Crystal and Jessica Jung, anemia. Jung sisters are no strangers in the K-pop entertainment industry. Despite their professional life being 100% on point, they are not doing that well when it comes to their health department. For the fans of the girls, it's probably old news that these two icons suffer from a medical condition called anemia. If you are a victim of this ruthless disease, you are most likely experiencing dizziness, breathing problems, incredible exhaustion, and you feel terribly weak. Although anemia can be temporary, it's unfortunately not the case of the Jung sisters. Probably one of the most horrifying events in Crystal's career must be when she fainted during an FX performance in 2010. Similar thing happened in 2014 at an SM Town concert in Shanghai after she performed the song Red Light with her group. Right after the lights went down, she rushed from the stage and lost her consciousness. All of this happened because of her anemia. When you combine it with a tiring schedule, lack of sleep, and daily stress, you'll quickly understand how hard it is for Crystal and Jessica to keep being in the spotlight. It sees Yeji, atopy. To fall sick is one thing, but to suffer literally to the point of your parents getting scared of losing you is something completely else. Yeji is not only a beautiful woman, but she is also a total sweetheart. During one of her V-Lives, she opened up about a traumatic experience that she as a child had gone through. Yeji suffers from a disease called atopy, and people who have this condition diagnosed are very vulnerable to various allergies and they can fall sick in a blink of an eye. When Yeji was only 8 years old, she caught a cold and she thought that if she just took the medicine, everything would be fine. So she rushed it a lot, but her cold wasn't going away. Her mother took her to the hospital, and that's the point where it got really scary. The doctor immediately made several tests and found out that Yeji got severely sick, which resulted in her getting pneumonia because of Atobi. She also revealed that she doesn't remember everything because she would wake up, then fall unconscious again several times during the day. Yeji was taken to the largest hospital in Seoul, where the best doctors tried to come up with a solution just to avoid sending her to surgery. However, the story is extremely sad. On the first night in the hospital, doctors warned Yeji's mother that her daughter might not make it and that the worst thing may happen. Yeji said that, "I was hospitalized for almost a year, but I recovered." Although it's a terrible experience, she urged her fans to take care of their health because she's been through a lot herself. EXID's Seolji, hyperthyroidism. We all love EXID's music, there's no question about that. But many people know that one of the members, Seolji, has suffered from a very disturbing medical condition. The name of this strange disease is hyperthyroidism, and it's actually very unsettling. The condition affects mostly females because of the production of hormones in the thyroids. A person who is affected by this may experience extreme weight loss, rapid heartbeat, and among other things, fevers. In 2016, EXID's label released a statement in which they said that Seolji was diagnosed with this disease and that she had been suffering from multiple symptoms, including fever and the protrusion of her eyes. Now, the story gets much scarier. Seolji had immediately started to receive a treatment and had to undergo a surgery. She had parts of her eye sockets removed because this condition could have eventually led to her becoming blind. Everything turned out to be okay in 2018. Seolji announced on her Instagram that she came back from the doctor's appointment and she said that she had fully recovered from hyperthyroidism. She also addressed people who suffer from the same condition and encouraged them to never give up. She said, "To everyone else suffering from hypothyroidism, don't lose hope. If you attend treatments regularly, it's possible to make a full recovery." EXO's Lay, hemophilia. Who would have thought that one of the hottest men ever suffers from a very dangerous medical condition, and especially when he doesn't let it affect his life. Although Lay's condition is no joke, he fights through the hard times like a true warrior. His diagnosis is hemophilia, which is basically a disorder that prevents blood from clotting easily. So our guy is always in danger if he accidentally hurts himself. During his trainee days and right after the debut, he would often injure himself either on stage or while practicing. Everyone tried to keep him as safe as possible because people who suffer from hemophilia bleed longer than an average person. So yeah, one can only imagine how the rest of the group would freak out if Lay decided to cook himself a meal and cut some vegetables while doing that. On the lighter note though, Lay's music is freaking awesome and I highly suggest that you go and listen to all of his bops. Mamamoo's Moonbyul, congenital mirror syndrome. The condition that our dear Moonbyul is suffering from is something that many of us probably have already heard of, but don't know the correct medical term. The name sounds really crazy. It's congenital mirror syndrome. And I can't even say how frustrating life must be for the people who suffer from this. The syndrome makes them get used to a habit of doing the exact same movement on your right side of your body on your left side of your body. That's why it's called a mirror syndrome, because you are literally mirroring every little thing you do. However, when it comes to Moonbyul, she doesn't take this super seriously. She got used to it. I mean, what else could she have done, right? It's actually pretty funny because when she's, for example, holding a mic while singing, she has the urge to mimic the exact same movement with her other hand. Now, this pretty much complicates the choreographies because not every movement is mirrored, so Moonbyul has a lot of bad feelings to fight inside. Weki Meki's Choyojung, joint pain. Choyojung might be just 21 years old and look fresh as a daisy, but her health is far from okay. 2 years ago, she had to go on a hiatus because of her unbearable pain in her joints. Imagine being so young and experiencing constant pain while dancing, performing, practicing, or simply going through your life. Yojung herself shed some light on this whole situation by saying, "My joints aren't good. That's why when the pain gets really bad, I get pain medication injections into my joints." I can really only imagine how hard this must be to fight through those difficult moments when the pain really gets the best of you. Let's wish her the best and hope that she can feel a little better knowing that her fans are supporting her. Do you know any other idols who suffer from serious medical conditions? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Bye!